Hello and welcome to the Application Laboratories here at Metal Toledo. My name is Dominik Kukisberg and I'm an application specialist in titration. And today I'm here to show you how we determine the water content of gummy candies using our new EVA V3 Carl Fischer titrator and a homogenizer to help us. Gummy candies are not that easy to analyze. In Carl Fischer titration, the water needs to be fully released from the sample into the Carl Fischer solvent, and any solid sample that is insoluble or the gummy candies, which only dissolve very, very slowly, are challenging to measure. Therefore, we use a homogenizer, as you see here, which helps us dispersing the samples. And I have for you just three examples out of the food industry where homogenizers are most often used. Starting with the milk powder, which actually does not dissolve, it floats on top of the solvent, and the homogenizer helps us dispersing it. The almonds, very obviously, if I throw in a whole almond, it will never release its water. The homogenizer grinds it down to a fine paste. And finally, the gummy bears, which we will analyze today. Since they dissolve so slowly, maybe 15-20 minutes, the homogenizer brings this time down to less than 2 minutes. We support two brands of homogenizers. One is the ICA, the other one is the Kinematica. And for our applications, these deliver equivalent results. And today we have set up the whole system with the ICA homogenizer, and both of them can be controlled directly from the EVA, and I will show you quickly how this is done. If we navigate to the method, we can see in the method sequence there is a method function called homogenizer, and in this method function we have a speed and a duration which turns on the homogenizer for this certain amount at this speed. We've already set up the system for measurement, and I have filled the cell with a 3-to-1 mixture of methanol and formamide. The formamide helps us in dissolving the gelatin-based candies. And we've started the method, which has already pre-titrated the cell and is now ready for measurement. We recommend to measure blanks beforehand because the homogenizer can introduce an increased amount of water while running than just this standby situation here. And you would turn on the homogenizer for the exact same amount of time and the exact same speed as you do in the analysis, and measure the water content that is being added by this homogenization step. And we have already done these as well. I can show you the results here in the results screen, where you can see the three values that we have determined beforehand. Let's start the sample analysis. I've already cut off a small piece and teared it out on the balance. We don't need the full candy, and the pieces need to be small enough to get pulled into the homogenizer so that they get shredded efficiently. And so we start the sample. Now we're being asked to add it. I'll remove the stopcock. Add the piece of gummy bear. And once I accept it, the homogenizer will start. The sample weight is determined with the back weighing technique and is automatically transferred from the balance to the titrator. Now that the titration is done, we received our result, which can be seen on the screen, and it is well within the expected range. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you are interested in more information about Carl Fischer titration, please head to our website.